online classes. Dear students, today I am going to discuss with new chapter, that is the Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act 2012. Okay. Under chapter Role of the Tamil Nadu Commissioner for Protection of Child Rights with regard to Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act. Okay, what is that? Role of the Tamil Nadu Commissioner for Protection of Child Rights with regard to Protection of Children from Sexual Offences. The short term is POCSO Act 2012. POCSO, POCSO Act 2012. Now the recent cases also coming from this type only. Okay, because we are all modern peoples, but modern peoples don't know how to behave with a child. Okay, this is the main reason the law would enacted by the our parliament. Okay, here the role of State Commission for Protection of Child Rights is prescribed in section 44 of the POCSO Act 2012. Okay, and rule 6 of the POCSO rules 2012. Understand? As per this act and as per this rule, I will discuss with one by one, because this is elaborated one. Okay, recent cases also we are seeing many newspaper and all, 75 years old man, okay, sexual harassment with child, 2 years baby, 7 years child, 8 years, below 13 years. Okay, so we have to eradicate, this type of offenses. Okay, we'll give awareness to the all the peoples. Without awareness program, they will not change their minds also, because many peoples are ignorance of law. Not only ignorance of law, many peoples are addicted to their dirty mind. Okay, okay students, let's start our subject. As per this act, monitoring of implementation of the act, the SCPCR may collect information and data on its own or from the relevant agencies regarding reported cases of sexual abuse and their disposal under the process established under the Act, including information on the following. Okay, I'll give you. Number one, a number of details of offences reported under the Act. That means sources will be police, child welfare committee, special court, okay, and district child protection unit, that means DCPU, state child protection society, SCPS, district social welfare officer, DSWOS. These are all DSWOS are short form. Directorate of Social Welfare and Social Defense. Okay, number two, details of the number of cases filed under section Indian Penal Code or POCSO or exclusively under POCSO alone, etc. Okay, because based on this circumstance, sorry, the details of this section along with the subsection, synopsis of case, context of abused cases, gender variables and etc. For better understanding of the reported cases across the state. Number three, to monitor whether the procedure prescribed under the Act and rules were following, including those regarding transframes. Here, time frames. Here, the time frames to be monitored by State Commission for Protection of Child Rights. Short form is SCPCR. Okay. Fourth one, police to inform Child Welfare Committee and special courts within 24 hours. Number five, if police believe emergency medical care is needed, then they have to take the child for his care within 24 hours of complaint. Okay. Number six, police to ask for Child Welfare Committee assessment if they believe a child needs care and protection within 24 hours. Number seven, Child Welfare Committee assessment to be done within 3 days. Okay. Number eight, if child is ascertained by Child Welfare Committee as in need of care and protection and is assigned a support person, the Child Welfare Committee should inform the police or Special Juvenile Police Unit. Okay, short form is SJPU, who in turn should inform the special courts within 24 hours of making assignment. Number 9, evidence to be obtained by special courts 1 month from the time of committal. Number 10, trial to be over in 1 year, within 1 year. Okay. Number 11, state government should pay compensation ordered by special court within 30 days of receipt of order. Okay. And details of arrangements for care and protection of victims of offences under this Act, including arrangements for emergency medical care and medical examination. The Child Welfare Committee can decide on the place of staying of the child or victim, that is either family or any institutions. Details regarding assessment of the need for care and protection of child by the concerned welfare committee in any specific case. Okay. The State Commission for Protection of Child Rights request has to be in writing and acknowledged when received. And also, the State Commission for Protection of Child Rights may use the information so collected to assess the implementation of the provisions of the Act. The report on monitoring of the Act shall be included in a separate chapter in the annual report of State Commission for Protection of Child Rights under section 44 subclause 3 of the POCSO Act. Okay. The following are the other suggestions regarding the task to be undertaken with regard to the Act by State Commission for Protection of Child Rights. Here, one number of Tamil Nadu Commissions for the Protection of Child Rights need to be assigned to deal exclusively with the POCSO Act. Okay. A standard format has been developed for the State Commission for Protection of Child Rights to get the information from the relevant agencies like Child Welfare Committee and Police, etc. On monthly basis, that means subject to modification is required. Okay, it will assist the State Commission for Protection of Child Rights to keep track of the reporting of cases and monitoring of the same by State Commission. A standard format is given in Annexure 1. And also, monthly reports from the police can be sought in cases relating to sexual violence against children to tally with the cases being informed to Child Welfare Committee. A clear protocol should be developed, that is the necessity and the process, okay, so that there will not be duplication or replication, overlapping of any inquiry process. This will then ensure the seamless integration of all protection structures, systems and personnel involved in child protection with the best interest of the child as the paramount factor. Okay, and this chapter is further subdivided into 3 units. Number 1, recommendations of the Supreme Court of India on compensation, that is number 1. Number 2, guidelines to be considered while determining the compensation in case of child sexual abuse. Number 3, enhancement of compensation in special cases. Okay, now it's clear, viewers. Okay, we'll discuss with next online classes that subdivided 3 units one by one next online classes. Okay, viewers, all the best. Take care. This is for your information, because now many cases are increasing day by day, this type of child abuse, okay, child sexual harassment, and many educated person and uneducated person and many of relative persons also, many accused person involved in this area. So I kindly advise you, all of you, those who are watching in this video, please alert on your neighbors, number 1. Number 2, to assess and monitor your child. Number 3, spending your more time with your children. Number 4, interact with whenever you free. You just any type of question or and you can ask what is our interest, okay, and motivate in your child and give elaborative practical process and teach your children also, and don't stay along with any neighbor house or any relatives also, because in modern days I've seen many area those who are mingled with very close relatives, because I was seeing many cases those who are involved, those who are interact with close friendship or relative like that, cousin brothers, uncles or uncle sons, whatever it may be. Okay, so we don't know. I'm not blaming anybody, because we are seeing many cases through newspaper also in modern time. So many people are suffering and many people not give any complaint to a particular area, particular police station also, because they are hiding their wrongdoers, because they want to protect their family name. They don't know how to protect the legal system and all. So these are all legal ignorance. So I advise you all, through this video. Protect your child, those who are violate the our Indian law. You just intimate to nearest police station or discuss with your elders or discuss with your family lawyer, okay, or your close friends, and suggest. After that, we'll take necessary or appropriate action.